What is chill filtration, and why do so many distilleries chill filter their whiskey? Welcome back, Dram Fam, to the Whisky Diary. First things first, I'm going to try and keep this video a little less sciencey than maybe some of the others, and as a result there may be some slight oversimplification for those of you that are super sciencey, so I'm afraid you're going to have to bear with me on that. If the science is something that you're interested in, leave me a comment down below and get subscribed, because I plan to do some more kind of deep dives in some of the more sciencey aspects of whiskey production. But with all that out of the way, what exactly is chill filtration? Well, in short, chill filtration is cooling the whiskey down and filtering it. While the exact process can vary subtly from distiller to distiller, for the most part, they're chilling it down to somewhere between 0 and minus 10 and passing it through a number of filters at varying different grades and made of varying compounds. Down at that temperature, a lot of the water in the whiskey, because obviously it's still a minimum of 60% water, some of that water will freeze, and it does generally make the whiskey more viscous. I would highly recommend actually sticking, if you've got a dram of something down at 40-43%, stick it in the freezer overnight, pick it up the next day, give it a shake, pour it in a glass, and see quite how thick that is. So as a result, they have to force it through the filters at relatively high pressure. That entire process is the process of chill filtration, and it's designed to remove certain compounds from the whiskey. So why do distilleries chill filter their whiskey? Well, for the most part, it is to prevent the whiskey from going cloudy when it's exposed to low temperatures. You may find that in some whiskies, if you cool it down or add a little bit of water, you will start to see a little bit of a haze develop in the whiskey. It won't retain its crystal clear kind of transparency, opacity. Either way, it won't be crystal clear anymore. That is a result of long chain fatty acids, esters, and proteins, which are present in the barley. They are byproducts of distillation, they are byproducts of fermentation, and even some come from the maturation in a cask. Those compounds are soluble in ethanol, which obviously in a cask, the whiskey will be sitting at somewhere around 60%, so there's loads of alcohol for them to be dissolved into. But when it comes to bottling, and the strength of that whiskey is brought down to somewhere between 40 and 46%, when that goes into transport and the temperature can sometimes drop very low, you may find that the whiskey becomes cloudy. When that temperature gets brought down to those lower temperatures, those fatty acids will actually floculate, which is just a posh word for stick together. When they stick together, as they drop out of solubility, as they are no longer soluble in that much water down at that temperature, stick together and they create this haze throughout the whiskey, and they are literally just tiny, tiny particles which are then blocking light from getting through the whiskey and therefore appears hazy. Understandably, for some consumers, retailers and distillers, that's not a very desirable thing to see from your whiskey on a shelf. Now, you will often see a lot of whiskies that are bottled up at 46% and above, and that is because at those kind of ethanol concentrations, all of those esters and fatty acids can stay in full solution in the whiskey. So even if you do bring it down to those lower temperatures, you're not going to see that haze. There is obviously a lot of debate around this. Some distilleries will keep their whiskey bottled up at 50% and will chill filter a lot of their whiskey, even those bottled up at 46% and above. Other distilleries won't chill filter at all, which kind of raises the question, what effect does chill filtration have on whiskey? It's generally regarded as a common misconception that chill filtration has any effect on the flavour of whiskey. Now, I'm not really going to come out here and tell you whether it does or does not have an effect. What I am going to do is provide evidence and facts which support both sides of the argument. For instance, in bourbon, many bourbon distilleries will filter their whiskey in order to mellow it out and reduce some of the harsher grain notes. So there's an instance where filtration is used in order to change the flavour of whiskey. In Japan and Taiwan, they quite often filter any rice spirits, again, to reduce some of their harshness. And vodka is chill filtered often several times and is widely touted as being chill filtered in order to keep the flavour clean. Now, the point of chill filtering is to remove certain fatty acids and esters from the whiskey. Arguably, those particular compounds aren't strictly flavoursome or aromatic and don't impart a huge amount of flavour to the whiskey, although again, that is debatable. Another thing that chill filtration removes are fusel alcohols, which are heavier alcohols other than ethanol, which are in very, very small quantities in the whiskey. But a lot of people claim that they add to like a waxy and oily mouthfeel. And several distilleries claim, you know, when you look at the filter plates after the whiskey has been filtered, there is a thick, oily substance left behind on those plates. And so without that being present in the whiskey, there's an argument that it can alter that mouthfeel and the overall drinking experience. On the flip side of that, a lot of people claim that by removing those harsher, more pungent alcohols and esters that may be present in the whiskey allow more delicate flavours to stand out, whereas usually they would be masked by other flavours which were present as a result of the distillation process, as opposed to coming from the raw ingredients used. A lot of distilleries talk about the uniqueness of the places where they make their cuts, which essentially is when you distill whiskey, you know, you start off with some spirit coming over the still and you choose a point to cut it, and then they become your hearts, which is what goes into the bottle or the barrel fundamentally. And then you cut it again and they become the tails, and you know, they go back into the next batch to be redistilled. It's those heads and tails, as they're called, which contain a lot of those heavier and more complex alcohols. A lot of distilleries put a lot of focus on where they make their cuts, and you know, that's part of their identity as a distillery. The chill filtration process can kind of reverse some of that and can really contribute to, again, the overall fingerprint of a distillery. So it's quite important to take that into account as well. Maybe the effects of chill filtration can be negated or in some way attenuated by changing where your cuts are. It's probably also worth noting that in some instances, you make the cuts where you do because you know the whiskey is going to be chill filtered. The big question really is, does it matter? Well, that's up to you. Do you mind cloudy whiskey? Do you maybe want to potentially taste the spirit in its purest, rawest form? And then you make the decision to knock it down to those lower ABVs at the risk of it becoming cloudy? Do you think that you can tell the difference between a chill filtered and non-chill filtered whiskey? It's become a big point of contention. It's also become a bit of a statement for a lot of distilleries to say, you know, we no longer chill filter our whiskey. I believe it was back in 2010 when Bern Stewart Distillers, who own Bunnahavan and Tobermory, their master blender kind of encouraged that group of distilleries to raise their ABV to 46.3% and remove chill filtering from the process. For me personally, I generally do prefer the higher ABV of whiskies. I think at those higher ABVs, it gives you a chance to get a little bit more excitement out of the alcohol. Essentially, the ethanol is the flavour carrier, and so it's that extra ethanol that's theoretically providing you more flavour into your whiskey. When you drink it and it hits your tongue, that alcohol is going to evaporate and release a lot more of those flavours. Some people don't necessarily want that much excitement. They might not even want that ABV out of their whiskey. Maybe they're looking for something a little bit more relaxed, a little bit more chilled out, and just a little bit easier on the mouth in general. And in those instances, you know, there's a big argument there for why those whiskies are chill filtered and why many of the consumers would want them to stay chill filtered. At the end of the day, it is up to the consumers to make those choices. And I'd love to know your thoughts on this. I know lots of people have lots of things to say about chill filtration. I also know an awful lot of people that could not care less and didn't even know it was a thing, which is why I've made this video. But anyway, that's enough from me. Thank you all very much for watching. If you've liked this video or if you found it in any way informative, please do drop a like down below and comment. What are your thoughts on this subject? It's always super interesting to hear. And of course, if you would like to hear a more sciencey approach to this kind of subject, again, let me know down in the comments and I'll do my best. If you'd like to support the channel, please do consider subscribing. And if you're subscribed already, hit that bell icon to be notified whenever I upload. And on that note, by the way, this is the Aaron Sherry Cask and it's absolutely stunning. Massively considering doing a review on this. But anyway, Slangevar.